Okay. Trigby. Okay, perfect. So we didn't get injured. I was just about to say, I want to see what happens with the witch. So you saved me, a woman shouts from somewhere among the clansmen. You saved me when the others would have let me die. You recognize the woman as the witch you cut free from the trees. White leaves will blow once more across the plains, and punish those who stood in our way. You step towards her, calming the gathering crowd. I'm not sure what you're talking about, but no one is standing in your way if you wish to leave. When the woman sees you, she smiles. What a handsome man, she says, reaching crooked fingers towards your face, but stopping before she touches you. My people have hidden food in the next copse of trees. Take it in good health. Without another word, she walks off into the countryside alone. Okay. And we just foraged for... Damn, we got 30 days worth. Well, on that note, let's train up some people. Let's train... 50 should be good. Now it's pretty much even across the board. So many supplies. Whispers from the clansmen grow in volume with every step towards the colorful, daunting old wood. Nothing but game trails into this place, Ivor says. This many people? I don't like it. He looks agitated, nervous. Glancing around, you notice the other Varl, and even the Horseborn, acting similarly. Tight places like this don't sit well with us, he says. Watching you. No room to stand or swing, just another place I don't belong. Ivor's growing concerned with feeling useless is somewhat puzzling, but you keep it to yourself. For all its majesty and storied paths filled with legendary hunts, the dense foliage and spore-filled air of the old wood feels eerie. Scouts report subtle movements around you. We're being followed. Studied, maybe, she says. Can't tell how many. It's like they disappear if you look directly at them. Grab some fighters to join you in a patrol. You decide to take the offensive and gather some fighters. As the caravan continues forward, your small group makes several laps, checking rock outcroppings and clumps of trees. While you find nothing, you cannot shake the feeling the scout is right. Calls a young girl in front of you and a crowd of others. Caught her stealing enough food to feed a starving Varl, the woman says. Not the first time I've seen her at it either. The girl looks familiar. She's part of the thin group of humans you picked up on the trail. Just return the food. Her people will punish her. The girl looks ashamed as her mother loudly berates her. Others offer switches to the mother to teach the girl a solid lesson as the caravan moves on. A sudden rumble underfoot is strong enough to make you grab the side of a cart for balance. After it ends, you notice a young girl crying when her brother puts an arm around her. That's just the way it is around here, he says. Nothing to cry about. Oddly looks concerned. I'm not sure if that's the right attitude or not, she says. It keeps them from being worried all the time, but it keeps them from being cautious as well. What's the point in caution, Harvey says. The ground. If it is that massive serpent causing these quakes, it could be an arrow's range away and we'd never know it for all these trees. His words do little to quash the acrid dread in your gut. So we're gonna grab a... We're gonna rest up, improve our morale. The faint smell of smoke goes unnoticed by many except you and a few others, including the horseborn. It's coming from the south, Ivor says. Ettingberg, if the map is right. It'll take us some time to get there. Rorich and Juju are unleashing strings of angry sounds and pointing to hoofprints leading south through the woods. Clansmen watch them with concern. You consider what to do. What are the horseborn doing? Rorich turns his back to you. Juju struggles to understand your words, finally saying, Destroy. Your look of confusion brings Skahatch over. This herd, he points at the hoofprints, enemy. Burwich hates Twitch Campay. You cannot understand the last word he said, or the sounds thereafter. Mean leader who wants things, all things ruined, burned, almost kill Rorich, then meeting you. You consider what to do. Let's see if we can help. While she doesn't understand your words, your movement towards the village prompts Durdriu to move forward quickly. Only Rorich is able to slow her and keep her near the caravan. Your arrival through the smoke is unexpected by the hoofed pillagers. Some unite to hold you off, while others, smeared in blue war paint, flee into the surrounding woods. Okay. So we need the horseborn. We will take our all-star archer. We will also take Ivan, and I guess Ivor. We should probably promote some of these people up. Because they have low armor but decent strength. Could also use a mainline tank. I think Ivan's going to be good in mitigating damage from a range. We need Ivor to go in and do a bunch of straight up damage without getting surrounded. And the Mender to keep him healthy. Which leaves these three. What is their role going to be in this fight? Well, we need people to break armor. She's gonna do range damage. And right now he's kind of tanking. Maybe. Okay, so I think this is gonna be it. But we're gonna need all stars at the front. Skyhatch has all the break. He's gonna go before Nid. Do something like this. We all have items. I think this will be good. Okay. So this beastly figure here, if we can take him down, we should be able to win the fight. We have three ranged. Seems to be their common unit. They have quite a bit of armor break. I want to get Ivor in range to hit this guy right off the bat. Or not Ivor, sorry, Ivan. As soon as possible. We're just going to shuffle these two around because we want, based on turn order, we don't want to block anyone if they need to move forward. So Arbor's going to move up, try to swing. They're probably going to move into him. We need a big tank. We do not have one. Alright, so we're just gonna focus this guy. He just ran straight into our... or straight into us, so...
Yeah.
The enemy leader charges you, just take him out, right? Vertebrate is 6 here. And of course, it's Nid, so she's gonna crit. Reach. It's gonna take him out already. That was the quickest fight ever. 6 renown because we didn't kill many enemies, but I'm okay with that. With the marauding horseborn defeated, the Varl and clansmen quickly douse the fires around the village. We can never repay you, the villager leader states, but we will spread word of what you did here today, across the woods and hills. Thank you. The governor looks at you from a distance and nods once. I guess he liked that.